Today on BRStv, we're going to install an auxiliary color module to the Vertex Illumina. The ability to upgrade and modify the fixture is a pretty nice feature. While I wouldn't say it makes the unit future-proof, it certainly adds an obvious upgrade path and greatly extends the long-term value of the fixture. With most fixtures, you're more or less stuck with whatever colors or technology the light came with when you purchased it. The Illumina allows you to add these auxiliary pads with whatever new color spectrum the industry develops. For instance, the color pad that we're going to install today has two red, one green, one upper range UV, one violet, two indigo violet, and one warm white. Even after installing all this, we still have upgrade slots available when new spectrums emerge. On a related but slightly different note, you're about to see how easy these pads are to install, and it's basically the same step should you ever need to replace one of the primary modules years from now. The ability to easily replace primary components like this greatly increases the effective lifespan and value of the fixture. The first step of installing a new module is to unscrew the end cap of the fixture. Make sure you unscrew the blank end without the LCD panel. Once you have all the screws out, slide the end cap off and remove the acrylic shield. Next, locate the installation kit you purchased with the auxiliary module and snap the sides off so you can use a smaller portion. Some of the modules might also require you to remove a peg from the kit as well. Insert the module into the installation kit and then run a small bead of thermal compound in a straight line on the opposite side of the LEDs. To make sure you're installing the module in the right direction, just make sure the open end of the fixture is on your right-hand side and you can read the word press. Make sure that word isn't upside down. Then push down as hard as humanly possible to make sure the pins pierce the cord and the module is seated properly. You can now place all the screws into the holes and begin tightening down the pad. Note that I'm using the long end of the tool in the screw. This allows me to tighten it down securely without applying too much torque. If you use the tool in the other direction, it's possible to apply a significant amount of torque and possibly strip the screw. Once you have the screws in, remove the installation kit and attach the wire harness with the small end first, followed by the larger end. All you need to do now is reassemble the unit by sliding the shield back in place and reinstalling the end cap. If the module you're installing is relatively new, you'll probably also need to update the programming software on your PC and the Illumina's firmware using the V-Link. The closer the PC is to the light, the better. We suggest using a laptop near the light or bringing the light to your PC for this process. The latest software and firmware can be found on Vertex's website. If you have any trouble finding it, shoot us a quick email or chat request, and one of our customer service agents can send you the link. That wraps up today's episode. If you'd like to be notified when new episodes come out, subscribe to our YouTube channel or visit bulkreefsupply.com and sign up for our newsletter. Thank you for watching BRStv.